Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Czabecast. Czabe, Scotty, Al, Low Def, we're all here. Well, 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 well. NBC has got its tit in a ringer, doesn't it?
What?
Well, it's an expression.
Okay.
It's uncomfortable.
Sure.
Why would your nipple be in a ringer ever? I don't know, but apparently that's an old expression.
Balls in a vice?
If that's you have another, a safe word, it's
maybe
okay.
You like
okay.
That sort of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Marv Albert, yes!
And you say fetish.
Yes. No. This Conan Leno thing is unreal. The Conan, or the Leno show lasted how long before they pulled the plug? They started this thing when?
7 weeks, I think. No, seven
they
months,
started,
I mean. 7 months.
Was it Conan, 7 months? They started in June, Leno at 10 o'clock?
I think so, yeah, during the summer.
Yeah, and Conan recently joked, hey, I'm the guy who as a child grew up watching Johnny Carson saying, someday I'm going to host that show for 7 months.
That's pretty funny.
He's done a lot of really good stuff. He he openly mocked NBC's losing 200 mil for the Olympics and then turns to the audience and says, is it me or is it just really, really funny?
Must be nice to have super powerful agents and be able to cap on your
employer. Letterman's done the same thing, too.
Well, right. Letterman's famous for doing that, ripping CBS constantly
for
years.
Yeah, but he wasn't shooting. These guys are shooting.
Define shooting, Galdi.
Going off the script and saying things that are too close to reality for comfort.
Right. Letterman would always kind of chide GE, the parent company,
right.
At the time of being pinheads.
Right.
But this is real heat, as you would say in
this
wrestling.
This is legit. Yeah.
Letterman, actually, Zabe, you love 30 Rock. Letterman recently also referenced, said Tina Fey and 30 Rock having a hard time coming up with dumb executives, you know, that are dumber than the ones currently.
Right.
Just taking open, it's open season for him over on CBS.
I think Jack Donaghy, the character Jack Donaghy, worst CEO ever, would be better than Jeff Zucker, who screwed this up royally by saying, hey, here's a great idea. Let's go cheaper in the 10 o'clock hour, because we're in fourth place. We can't script a good show that'll beat CSI or anything else. And we'll make money in volume because we're paying Jay and his cohort so much less than a primetime drama. Great idea! And as soon as those executives heard cheaper, it was like, huh?
Done and done.
Yeah, well, that'd be great. And then the affiliates got wind of it, and the affiliates' ratings started tanking. And they're like, screw this. We're not going to carry this show. And that's when it all fell apart. You can't just punt the 10 o'clock hour.
It seems like a good idea, though. A late-night talk show at 10 o'clock? Yeah, I mean, most people, a lot of people, aren't awake at 11:30 to 12:30 every night. And 10 to 11 is a feasible thing.
You also have to give it time.
But it wasn't thought through, though.
I think you also have to give it time. You can't pull the plug 7 months. And I don't know about you. I am not a Leno guy. And to me...
No, I don't think he's that funny either.
Yeah, and so I don't know that he's the right guy to be doing that.
There's that, and then there's Conan's basic statement is, give me a lead-in. Johnny had a lead-in. And the lead-in, again, you go back to... think about Leno with Friends and Cheers and Carson and what was great about NBC.
ER for 12 years.
You would stay there, watch their news, and at 11:30, I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, but instead of trying to find the next ER, they just said, we're going to cut corners and cut costs and throw Leno warmed over in the 10 o'clock hour.
Yeah.
Agreed.
Doesn't work. Go find the next ER. Go find the next ER. Oh, but we'd have to pay a guy like George Clooney, and he costs a lot of money and more a tyranny.
But those shows get amazing ratings and make money back for the network,
yes,
don't they?
Unless they bomb. Unless it's Southland or Cop Rock
I guess.
Super Train or something like that. Then they. But you know, the pain of not being able to find a hit show can't just cause you to punt, throw your hands up, which is what NBC did. Idiotic decision. Now they're paying for it. And they're worried that, oh, we're going to lose one of the two guys. Well, look, honey. Pick one. At this point, pick one, let the other one go, and move on. You're not going to keep both and be happy.
Leno's like 60, isn't he?
Yeah, if it was me, I'd keep Conan.
Yeah, I love Conan.
Better.
He's hilarious.
Andy Richter's a riot, and now, you know, somebody else said, too, that NBC's good at one thing, developing late-night talent. There's only one place to put him. And now you got, you know, a couple, and Fallon's fine. He's fine. He's not Conan or Leno.
And Jimmy Fallon is a piece of shit. Peter Griffin would say.
All right, thanks for listening, everybody. We will see you next time.